How you doing, baby?
I'm all right, baby. We here to talk about, I was in there washing dishes, and they said something about some Big Self.
Yeah, the Big Self. Big
Big Self. Christmas time is here. Everybody knows there's not a better time of year. Hear that sleigh. Santa's on his way. Hip hip hooray for Christmas vacation. Got a ton of stuff to sell. Well, that's the Big Six, though. Now it's getting closer.
Merry Christmas, Winter High School.
Fall comes to an end, and winter is finally here.
We have some interesting news for you before you leave for Christmas break.
Football, the Festival of Trees, and basketball.
And are the kids going to get toys or technology this year?
And why did Sonic cross the road?
We'll have this and more coming up after this.
Your beard is as white as snow. Your nose is like a cherry. Your stomach jiggles like a bowl of jelly.
Say it. Say it.
You're Santa Claus.
EACC is sharing their Christmas spirit with the community. Chelsea Andrews has more.
Tis the season at EACC. The Cross County Arts Council sponsors the Festival of Trees, where clubs and organizations come and set up Christmas trees in representation of themselves, a great way to get in the Christmas spirit.
Erin Wright tells why she chose to decorate a Christmas tree.
Well, our office wanted to do something to represent the community, to do something that we felt, you know, was a significance to our office. So we thought that doing something for making a tree that represented our office was something that we could do for the community.
Adarius Wallace explains how the trees impact the community.
I believe it's good for the community because it brings the community together, and with all the things going on today between stress, between parents and kids, you know, it just brings together on a different atmosphere and a different aspect and having fun.
Erin tells how decorating a tree results in Christmas spirit.
Decorating a Christmas tree always puts you in the Christmas spirit. It's just something about putting decorations on the tree and doing something to make the tree look pretty absolutely makes you put you in a Christmas spirit.
Wallace describes the event of decorating the tree.
Well, I had a good time because it brought our class together. We was all together on one accord having fun, and it's different between just going and doing something on a computer and like being stressed out, and we just had a good time and having fun.
Wright also explains how she believes Festival of Trees helps the community.
I think the Festival of Trees affects the community. It's something that a lot of the businesses and organizations do and put a lot of time and effort in, and it's something that the whole community can enjoy and go up and look at.
I'm Chelsea Andrews with Jacket Action News.
Since this is a television production class, our commercial breaks are going to be a little bit different this month. We thought we'd include one Christmas tradition that people enjoy with their families, growing more popular each season: classic television Christmas movies. During each break, we'll go to Kenan and Chelsea with lighthearted movie reviews, and here's the first one.
Chelsea.
Oh, hey, I gotta go. Hello, hey.
Supposed to be doing a movie review?
Oh, yeah. I was just dealing with stuff. You know.
Yes.
You know. Okay, yeah. Yeah.
Okay. So, the first movie. I say let's watch The Grinch.
I was going to pick that one.
I mean, I don't know. My family doesn't watch Christmas movies.
Really? Mine does. Yeah, it just brings a family together. It's like something that really just gets us in the Christmas spirit, and it's really fun. The Grinch is a good movie. You can choose it.
All right. Okay, let's watch the Grinch.
All right, let's go. Oh, wait. Not a movie is good without popcorn.
Right. Yes. Popcorn. Yes. Perfect.
All right, let's go. Excuse me.
I mean, popcorn, throwing, why?
What's your name? Oh, I thought I know you. Thought your granddaddy was named
John.
Give me, baby.
Uh-huh.
Ooh,
this
movie about to be good. What is this?
The Grinch.
No?
The Grinch.
The Grinch?
The Grinch.
Ah, my bad. Yeah, okay. What's it about? What? All right, then. It's a good popcorn. You got your song? Want some of mine? Want some of mine? Oh, okay, then. I got the extra butter. Mm-hmm. My bad. Oh, my bad. How you doing? My name is Bernice Janger. I'm just coming to you. My name is Bernice. I ain't even introduced myself. You go to church? Huh? Where you go to church at? What you whispering for? I can't hear you. Oh, something else hit me off. Yeah. Oh, all right. Okay. I got a granddaughter. She can't resist. I got grandson too. He a thief. I think I had to wear my good teeth to school. Oh, God. I think I had to wear my good teeth. Oh, my teeth. Want some of that popcorn? Popcorn. It's good. It's good. Just taste it. Don't take a whole bunch. I got to have some. Okay. Don't throw something after me. Don't throw something after me. I got something there to hold you.
All right, that was a really good movie, wasn't it?
Yeah, that was. That was real good.
I'm probably going to watch that before, huh?
I ain't take
that movie. I think I'm going to watch that before Christmas.
Yes, I will too. That was a really good movie.
It's my favorite. It gets me in the Christmas spirit. It's really good.
It does.
Do you like that?
I love that movie. That was real good.
The future farmers of America travel far distances to make the world a better place.
When you hear the word agriculture, do you think of plants, vegetation, and other life sources? Here at Wynn High School, our agriculture classes, along with FFA, have working on many projects based on natural resources. The goal of agriculture is to help students develop skills that will be helpful later in life. They also gain skills to handle daily life as an adult. Junior Tori Cartiller explains the hardest part about being an agri.
Like, it's all pretty easy, but you really have to pay attention, and I just love learning about agri because my dad's a farmer and everything, and it's really just natural.
Also, Jessica Kennedy explains what she thinks is the hardest part about being in agri.
Not really a hard part. You just got to pay attention in class and listen to the teacher.
Some students stated that they enjoyed the hands-on learning the most, along with woodwork. The latest projects of agriculture include duck blinds, picnic tables, storage buildings, bookcases, dressers, birdhouses, and many more. Also, Cartiller explains what she enjoyed most about the FFA trip.
Getting to meet new people, and I love the Brantley Gilbert concert. That was really fun. But we get to meet people from all over the country, and most of the time you talk to them almost every single day.
FFA sponsor Mr. Jones stated that the Future Farmers of America promotes leadership, personal growth, and career success. The motto of FFA, learning to do, doing to learn, earning to live, and living to serve. Kiana Waits, Jacket Action News.
All right. Okay, it's my turn to choose a movie. It's my turn.
Sorry.
Gosh.
My bad.
All right, I think This Christmas is a good one.
This Christmas?
Yeah. This Christmas with Chris Brown in it, you know?
Chris Brown, I know.
I know that Chris Brown, boy.
Oh, do you?
Uh-huh. That's my niece's nephew, boy.
Oh.
Uh-huh.
Can I get an autograph?
No, he don't like to do all that. Oh, yet. I can't do all that.
Okay, all right. Well, we're going to start this movie, and we'll let you know what we think of it.
What?
We're about to start a movie.
Hold up. My grandson coming. Wait a minute. I think he coming.
My name Lil Dad.
What?
My name Lil Dad.
Turn that up. The movie about to start. Oh, my bad, dear.
You told them 6 o'clock, right? You should have told them 4, because then they would have been here on time.
Where your Christmas spirit at?
Come on. You're tired of me.
There's nothing like the holidays.
This is a movie review, so, you know, can you keep it down? Just a little bit.
Make them articulate.
Keep it down.
To make you want to come home.
What's with that thing,
man? My ladies, you want to spend time with brother.
It ain't different.
Just pass the plate over here and I'll chew it for him, too.
Shut up.
Out.
I'm good
about
myself.
I want to
go, too.
You want something in? You don't. You fresh? Oh, I got choked.
He's in jail.
Ooh, dude, that's the wrong thing, huh? I don't need no more of that.
Sit up when I'm talking to you. Are you
okay? Oh, my Lord. Yeah.
Merry Christmas.
How y'all doing back there? Y'all need some popcorn? I got some popcorn. Y'all want some popcorn? Y'all want some popcorn? And I'm just trying to ask y'all to know have popcorn. Ooh.
That sounds like a really good movie.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, I really couldn't watch it because,
you know.
But,
somebody.
Hi. Huh?
He wasn't talking to you. I'm sorry. I'm trying to control him.
I was in the Holy Spirit.
Anyway, so that movie is definitely one that I want to watch. I haven't seen it before, but I heard it was really good, and I want to watch that.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
With technology steadily increasing, children aren't as anxious about toys as they were in past years.
A new laptop, tablet. Oh, what is calling? I think maybe like an iPhone 5.
I want an iPhone 5.
Techs or toys for boys and girls? That's the question for our Christmas holiday. Each year, Santa Claus requests have an elf size change. This year, he's checking his list twice.
Since 1972, when Magnavox introduced the first video game, The Odyssey, technology changed the ideas of toys forever, along with the choices made by children. Fifth grader Chase Bradley explains.
Well, I want an iPhone, and I think other kids prefer technology over toys because you can do more stuff with it.
Today's youth ask for technology rather than toys, but why?
Well, I think the world is changing. It's 2012, almost 2013. Technology is everywhere, and so students are using more technology now instead of playing with the old traditional type toys.
The digital revolution doesn't just aim to entertain, but gives children a total package of interaction.
Well, I think it's the stimulation that they receive from that. Good eye-hand coordination. They are engaged a little bit more. The different levels, too. In technology, they're trying to achieve a goal, and so they're finding that they're more successful.
So, Cadence, what do you want for Christmas?
An iPhone.
An iPhone. I'm Sydney Moore with Jacket, Action News.
All right, Chelsea, the last and final movie review of the whole movie review.
Right. Oh, I got one. All right, ready?
What's that?
All right, The Christmas heart. Oh, get out of here.
I got a Christmas heart. My heart is full of Christmas.
That was the coincidence that we both picked the Christmas heart.
Yeah, we both said that.
So, I'll get it. Before y'all start the movie, let me call it. Bridget!
Oh.
Bridget, get in here right now. Don't make me come out there. You better get in there right now. First you gonna make me get up. Come here.
Huh?
Come here. Sit down. Can she sit right here?
Sure.
They don't mind. Scoot over. Scoot over. They don't mind. Yeah, how you? This is my granddaughter, Precious.
Oh, hi. Hi, Precious.
Hello.
Hi.
All right. We're about to watch just be quiet. Don't say nothing now. Don't say nothing now. Don't say nothing now.
Okay.
Start the movie.
Okay. All right. Let's start.
Uh-huh. You get the popcorn like I told you. Get that popcorn.
Mm-hmm.
You got that popcorn?
Yes.
Uh-huh. Give me that popcorn. You ain't gonna eat that popcorn.
If you believe that Santa's really real,
that's the very best thing you can do for Madeline.
You know. Terry Polo will bring her family together.
I believe with all of my heart that it is not his time to go.
For a Christmas miracle.
This is so sad.
One of the 12 new movies of Christmas.
Can't you just feel it in your heart?
Don't miss The Christmas Heart. Tonight. Oh, yeah. Part of Countdown to Christmas, only on Hallmark Channel, The Heart TV.
Y'all all right down there?
Yeah, we're good.
Now I'm crying my shoulder. We can cry together. Oh, Jesus.
With the new Sonic in and the old Sonic out, why exactly did they change locations? Jeffrey Vong has the answers.
After having much success at the previous location, serving 500,000, everyone's wondering, why did the Sonic cross the road?
So, Terry, why do you think the Sonic crossed the road?
To expand their parking lot and to get more customers.
I guess they just needed more room.
I have no clue.
Because maybe for a better area to get more customers and to be seen.
Just probably like an upgrade maybe so they'll have a bigger expansion on their business.
With space being an issue at the previous location, Erwin Ridge explains what the new Sonic provides.
The primary difference between the old Sonic and the new Sonic is just the fact of needing more space. We have more stalls, we have more space on the inside. We had reached a level of volume where we needed more people to be able to get the job done more efficiently. And by acquiring more space, we've done that.
Now, the question everyone is wondering about. Why did the Sonic cross the road?
Biggest reason is simply because we needed to upgrade. We needed a new store. We needed to stay close to our own location as far as where we were located, which, as you can tell, we're about a rock's throw away from where we were. As probably most business people will know and understand that location is probably the most important aspect of any business operation. And to maintain the closeness to where we were was extremely important. So to go across the road was the best idea.
And with the Jacket Action News, I'm Jeffrey Vaughn.
Feliz Navidad. Feliz Navidad, Feliz Navidad, próspero año y felicidad. Feliz Navidad, Feliz Navidad, Feliz Navidad, próspero año y felicidad. I want to wish you a Merry Christmas, I want to wish you a Merry Christmas. Prospero año y fe.
time for sports, I'm Blake Manis.
And I'm Tristan Hill. Fall sports have just come to an end, and winter sports have just begun. The football players developed into heroes. The Yellow Jackets become known in the small state of Arkansas.
As of 2012, the word football became redefined at Wynn High School, as the Yellow Jackets claimed the conference championship title and reached the semifinals for the first time since 2006. The undefeated season comes to an end, but the Jackets keep their heads held high. With a winning season and a conference championship title under their belt, the Yellow Jackets reflect on the best parts of the season. Senior lineman Tyler McElroy talks about his personal favorite.
The best part of the season this year would have to be probably whenever we beat Nettleton and it closed out the conference championship for us and it locked it down for us.
Memory, a way of holding on to the things you love and never want to lose. While having numerous memorable moments, Tyler also describes his number one memory.
The most memorable moment of the season was definitely beating Batesville. That was our biggest competition in the conference, and we felt after we did that, we almost secured the conference championship for us.
Becoming one of the top four in the 5A division and ending the season 7-0 in conference and 12-1 overall is an outstanding way to end the season. Sophomore DeAndre McGill dwells on what he'll miss most about this football season.
I had to say the senior class, you know, they was pretty good leaders to all of us, and we're really going to miss all of them.
Heart and motivation, key to reaching the way to the top. Senior Draylen Willis gives his opinion on the most motivational teammate.
The most motivational person on the team is Russell Bogan. And, you know, he gives us all. Everything he does, he just gives us all.
While the Yellow Jackets prepare for next season, the community anticipates for another successful season. I'm Hannah Williams with Jacket Action News.
The Lady Jackets get back to the fundamentals as they look to improve before conference play.
Basketball is a team game. Lady Jackets are a perfect example of that this year.
Senior Hannah Williams tells us what the team is doing better this year.
I think the team is doing better this year because we're playing more team basketball and we have a better team bond than we have in years past. And plus, we're going by the phrase, top four believe. And we say that every time we break because we want to be one of the top four teams in the state tournament. So I think that's motivating us more to do better this season.
Head coach Karen Sanders further explains the meaning of the motto, top four.
On our practice t-shirts, we have it says top four. Top four indicates that the top four teams in our conference are able to go to state. And there's a separation between the top four and the bottom four. Those top four get after you. They get after loose balls. They go after everything they have. They leave their heart on the floor. And you can see, and they have each other's back. And you can see that on the top four teams. If you look at Paragould and what they've done, and they made it to the state finals and see how they play. And our job is to mock that and to get into top four this year to make it to the state tournament.
After starting their season off with the victory, the Lady Jackets scramble for answers as they drop five straight games. Coach Sanders explains what needs to be done if the Jackets want to be successful this season.
We have to go back to playing like we did at Hughes, which is playing team basketball. Our team cohesion then was very good, and we kept each other up, didn't let down, and did little things right, even when we had a chance to fall apart. Because of what we've done last year, and the times that we did fall apart, we learned and we've grown. And so we have to continue to grow and be successful and believing in ourselves and having confidence in our teammates.
Good luck to the Lady Jackets as they reach new heights. I'm Jeffrey Vaughn from Jacket Action News.
Man, you know, all the times we try to be on top of everything, you know. We never try to work for anything. But when you figure out that you gotta work to get to where you're at. You gotta put the work in to get the work out. And day in and day out, you try before team, nothing ever goes right. But when you put team before I, and everything gets together, and you win, you know all your work had paid off. It is not just because of you, but it's because of team effort, and it's what you put into it to get you to where you are.
On the basketball team this year, the boys strive for an outstanding season.
boys' basketball team jumps off the season with a record of 2-3, but with a new coach and new strategies, the boys' basketball team hopes to strive for a great season. Head coach Russell Jones says that the team's main goal on the court are to play team ball. With daily practices and hardworking team members, center Tasmania Jones tells what he thinks he can bring to the team as a team member.
As a team member, I think that I can bring excitement to the team. If I work hard and play hard, they'll do the same.
Also, Jones explains what he enjoys most about playing basketball.
I have to say the crowd. The crowd gives me excitement and adrenaline in the play.
The coach stated that the team's strongest strengths are size, speed, and experience. Guard Josh Sylvie explains what he will bring to the team this season.
To bring hard work, ethic, and skills in the guard position.
Sylvie also explains the differences between basketball season and football season.
Basketball is constant running, unlike football, which you get a break after every play. But hopefully we can get the same outcome, hopefully better than football.
On December 4th, 2012, the Jackets faced off against Jonesboro, ending the game with a score of 42-73. The boys' basketball team, well on their way. I'm Kiana Waits with Jacket Action News.
That's all we have for sports. We'll be back with Kendall and Nate after this.
I want a hippopotamus for Christmas. Only a hippopotamus will do.
You know, Kendall, Libdos have definitely been on our minds this semester.
They definitely have. And don't forget that Wynn High School is shooting a school-wide Libdub tomorrow. So come prepared. Wear blue and gold and bring your props.
That's all we have for news this month. Remember, the reason for the season.
The birth of Jesus Christ.
We'd also like to thank the Hobbs family for letting us use their home.
I'm Kendall Hobbs.
And I'm Nate Jenkins with Jacket Action News.